This is Nick Rosen. Welcome to Off-Grid News, our take on the on-grid world. Today, is the smart grid a dumb idea? The smart grid is the much-hyped upgrade to our tottering electrical network. But is it a silver bullet or the ultimate wrong turn in America's technological history? Now, the smart grid installs a meter in every home and business. It sends usage information back to the power company and other authorized third parties. The power companies combine this information with data from their power plants to match supply and demand. Once the system is fully operational, they will use all this data to change the price of energy on a minute-by-minute basis. But consumers will have no control over their data and little or no ability to enforce privacy. It's like rebuilding our entire airplane fleet, along with our runways and air traffic system, while the planes are all up in the air filled with passengers, says Peter Fox Penner, a principal with the Brattle Group consulting firm. That sounds scary. And the Brattle Group estimates that upgrading the smart grid will cost approaching $2 trillion, money that will be added to your energy bill. Now, corporate America wants to spend that money adding a layer of so-called intelligent technology to the existing grid, managing power flows more effectively and integrating renewable energy. The lobbying is intense as the infotech companies begin jostling with the utilities for control. Smart grid boosters include IBM, GE, the US Department of the Environment, the DOE, and American Electrical Power, AEP. The benefits on our side of the meter are substantial, said Michael Morris, chairman and president of AEP. So the utility companies feel it will benefit their bottom line. No surprises there, and nothing wrong with making a profit. But what if it damages the nation's energy security? Critics say it will hike prices for most consumers, threaten individual privacy with a new spy in the home, maintain existing inefficiencies in the system, which lose 50% of generated energy from one end to the other, and reduce energy security by creating hacker vulnerability. Above all, it will cost huge amounts of money at a time when money is tight and there are cheaper alternatives, says Carol Overland, a lawyer from Red Wing, Minnesota. The smart grid will merely cement into place all the things that are currently wrong with the grid, and then add a few more. Overland spends her professional life in utility commission hearings, trying to beat down the consumer price of electricity, gas, and water. The $400 billion a year electricity industry has not always had America's best interests at heart. The story of the building of the US grid in the early 20th century is one of shadowy forces led by GE, uniting through their advertising spend to create what they called an electrical consciousness. History is in danger of repeating itself. In 2009, a barrage of Super Bowl advertising heralded the new smart grid campaign.
The smart grid technology from GE will make the way we distribute electricity more efficient, simply by making it more intelligent.
I went back to the roots of the US power industry to analyze how we got here and where they want to take us next. As telecom lawyer and lobbyist Paul Bozzozzi of Peyton Boggs said, we're just kind of at the start of this process. Lobbying will be on a grand scale. Meanwhile, the sort of small solutions that are enabled by new technology are in danger of being overlooked. The locker vaults movement in Marin County outside San Francisco is pioneering a direct alternative. Local microgrids under the control of end users offer a cheaper and cleaner alternative. They are the antidote to the smart grid, says Pike Research, a respected energy consultancy. My book, Off the Grid, Inside the Movement for More Space, Less Government and True Independence in Modern America, contains a chapter which summarizes the history of the American grid. As America sleepwalks into the arms of big power, let's at least give the public the benefit of a debate. I want to hear from people who are interested in challenging this stranglehold the industry has on the issue at the moment. Contact me at nick@offgrid.net. In a future episode, we'll look at the smart grid from a European perspective.
Consultant with the rings.
In my head, I'd be scratching while my thoughts were busy hatching if I only had a brain.